This is a parent's worst nightmare, a picture of your child online being used and shared in a creepy way by strangers without your permission. For our next guest, that nightmare became a reality. This is the picture, the original picture, of her then 4-year-old daughter, Sullivan, posing with Hillary Clinton, and it was then used in a vicious meme and popped up everywhere. What did the mom do? And joining us now is that mom, Jennifer Jones, along with Jonathan Vick, Assistant Director of Cyber Hate Response at the Anti-Defamation League. Great to have both of you with us. Jennifer, I will start with you. Just for a little bit of background, let's explain your daughter, who was then 4 years old. She went as Hillary Clinton for Halloween. She loved Hillary Clinton. She idolized Hillary Clinton. And then she got a chance at a campaign event to meet her idol, Hillary Clinton, and she took that adorable photo. Then what happened, Jennifer, the day after Hillary lost?
Well, a friend of mine got in touch with me and told me that the image we held so dear to our hearts had been turned into a horrible meme put out by some people from the Trump campaign. And I was in shock and disbelief, and I felt very violated and helpless, and that I failed my child, that this was out there for the world to see.
And Jennifer, was it the Trump campaign? I just want to interrupt for 1 second, because I thought that you had traced it to a Facebook page, Men for Donald Trump. So just supporters of Donald Trump.
Yes, exactly. People that supported Donald Trump was where I initially traced it back to. And I found out that there was a Trump Facebook page, and I contacted them and asked them to remove it. Initially, they did not want to remove it.
But then ultimately they complied. But just take us back to that moment when you first saw. We're not showing the disgusting meme. We're not even characterizing it. But when you first saw it, just share with us that feeling of, oh my God, this is on the internet now.
I felt incredibly helpless because I've always heard that once things are on the internet, that they're there forever and there's nothing you can do. But I was determined, even if it was just me alone, to get it removed.
Yes.
Fortunately, I had friends and family that stepped in to help.
Right. So your friends sort of flooded the zone, and you contacted Pantsuit Nation, which was the Facebook community that supported Hillary Clinton, and they had an idea for you. Enter the Anti-Defamation League, and I want to turn to you, Jonathan.
Yes.
When you heard about this, this mother's plea, how can I ever get something expunged from the internet? Because we all know that's impossible, or we all think that's impossible. What did you do?
Well, there are certainly steps you can take at the outset to examine the situation, to look at the picture, to look at who owns the rights to the picture, and to start a chain of events that can certainly mitigate the problem and step in and be a friend to the people who are being affected and empower them to do something.
Okay, so Jennifer, when you had got word that there was, in fact, something you could do, how did you feel and what did you do?
I celebrated. I became very close with a lady named Sean from the Anti-Defamation League. She became my sister, my shoulder to cry on. Unfortunately, I've never had the opportunity to meet her. We will meet one day, we're sure of it. I speak to her daily. She has reassured me that this will be taken care of, and she was right, it was. And so much relief. We took that photo and we made it ours again, and it's something once again we're proud of. My daughter proudly displays it in her bedroom. Secretary Clinton signed it and personalized it to her.
Wow.
So it really truly is a family heirloom for us.
That is a great outcome. But what did you do, Jonathan? How did you get it off the internet?
Well, first we reached out to the Hillary Clinton campaign, who owned the rights to the photograph, asked them to institute what's called a DMCA takedown, Digital Millennium Copyright Act takedown notice, to Facebook and to a number of other places we found the photo.
Okay, so just let me stop you there. You figured out that if somebody took the photo, they own the rights to that photo.
Correct.
And anybody who puts it up is breaking the law.
Potentially not breaking the law. They are violating an agreement within the internet community regarding honoring of copyrights and the abuse of copyrighted material.
Can any of us use that? I mean, look, I think every person out there has things on the internet that they may not be comfortable with. Can anybody use this?
Yes, if you own the rights to the picture, to the video, that is your first and best recourse.
That is great, and this is a great lesson for everybody. Jennifer, we're so happy that this worked out well for you and your daughter, Sullivan.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for sharing the story with us. Jonathan, thank you for telling us that there is hope out there for people who think that the internet is forever. Thanks so much. Let's get to Chris.
A fair ending and a provocative question. What does Allison have on the internet that she is not happy with?